girls, and welcome back. It is so great to have each and every one of you with us today. So today, we'll be starting our new theme for the month. And it's all about you guys. It's all about children. So over this month, we'll be hearing some amazing stories of things that children did in the Bible and how God used them. Isn't that awesome and so exciting? So today, Teacher Shelley will be starting us off with a little story about why children are so important to God. But before we head over to her, let's open up in prayer. Father God, I thank you for blessing us with this beautiful day and for blessing us with the opportunity to come together online to learn more about you. I pray, Father God, that you would keep all the boys and girls and their families safe and keep them healthy. And I pray this in your amazing and almighty name. Amen. Are you ready for today's lesson? Awesome. Let's head over to Teacher Shelley now. Bye.
Hi, boys and girls. Welcome to today's lesson. It's been such a cold week. You see, I'm all snuggly. I've asked some friends to come and join me to keep warm. Whoa, that's lots of friends. Shoo. All right, I've got some to cuddle. So why don't you come closer and let's do story time. Are you ready? Today's story comes from Matthew chapter 18. And I'm reading from the storybook, the Jesus Storybook Bible. Because they say it so nicely. Story starts. Jesus' friends were arguing. Who was the most important helper in God's kingdom is what they wanted to know. I am, James said. No, you're not, said Peter. I am. Nonsense, Matthew said. I'm the cleverest. No, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Am too. And so they went on and on. They were so silly. You see, Jesus' friends thought that they needed to do something for God to love them or to make them special. But they forgot something true. Something God had been teaching his people all through the years. That no matter how clever you are, how good you are, or how rich or how nice you are, it doesn't make a difference because God's love is a free gift for anybody and all you have to do is reach out and take it. So while Jesus' friends were arguing, some people who knew about getting gifts came to see him. Who were they?
Kids!
Yes, they were kids, little children. Jesus' helpers noticed this and tried to chase them away. Jesus doesn't have time for you, they said. He's too tired. But they were wrong. Jesus always had time for children. Don't ever send them away, Jesus said. Bring the little ones to me. Now, what do you think? Did they sit there quietly? No ways. They ran to Jesus and they would cuddle in big hugs and play. Yeah.
Hi, Auntie Shelley.
Hello, Eeyore. Right, let's carry on with the story. It says, once Jesus had played with the children, he turned to his helpers and he said, no matter how big you grow, never grow up so much that you lose your child's heart, full of trust in God. Be like these children. They are the most important in the kingdom.
Yes, yeah.
So boys and girls, we need to remember as we're moving to this month of children and of youth that Jesus loves little children and that the way little children believe is the way God wants adults to believe too and love him and trust him with all their heart. So remember, children are important to Jesus. But no matter how small you are, you can make a difference. Have an amazing day. Hope you enjoyed the story and that you've got your friends to cuddle up. And have an amazing day. Bye.
Bye.